Hi students, welcome to day 4, 9th class English medium statistics. Yesterday we have discussed about the graphical representation of raw data and the measures of central tendency. We have 3 measures of central tendency. They are the arithmetic mean, second one median, third one mode. Yesterday, we have already discussed the arithmetic mean for raw data. So, what is the formula? The mean for raw data is equal to the sum of all observations by number of observations. From that, we have derived 2 auxiliary formulae and some of the applications we have discussed yesterday. So, now we are going to discuss the mean for ungrouped distribution table. Okay, so that is mean, that is arithmetic mean of ungrouped frequency distribution. Sometimes the observations were more and the one observation may repeat more times. That is why then we have to adopt 2 more formulae here. The mean for ungrouped frequency distribution, the first formula is a simple method or direct method. Simple method. Sometimes this is direct method to find the mean. So, mean is equal to sigma fi into xi by sigma fi. So, here observe that here fi is the frequency, ith frequency, and the sigma fi. Here, sigma fi is sum of all frequencies. Sometimes this is denoted by n also. And now here, xi is the ith observation and sigma fi into xi. Fi into xi means this is the product. Sigma means sum, summation. So, here sum of the products of fi and xi. So, when we have to use this formula, in the raw data, we used mean is equal to sum of all observations by number of observations. So, here we have to use this formula when the ungrouped frequency distribution table is given. So, let us take one example for this. Suppose here is a question like this, here xi and fi, that is the frequencies are here like this. Here the observations, xi is the observation. So, here the first observation is 5. 5 is repeated 3 times. Therefore, the frequency of 5 is 3. And next 10, here frequency is also 10, and 15 is the next observation, the frequency of this is 25, and next observation 20 is the frequency is 7, and here 25 and the frequency is 5. Find the mean. using direct method or simple method. Find the mean of this data. So now you can find the mean of the data. First you have to write this as a vertical table fi. So here xi, the observations 5, 10, 15, 20 and 25, these are the observations. So now what is the frequency of phi? This is 3 and 10, 25 and 7 and here 5. Okay, so here these two boxes were given. We have to find the mean through simple method. What is the mean? Here the formula mean x bar is equal to sigma fi into xi by sigma fi. These two values must be prepared from this table. So here fi is here. You can find the sum of these frequencies so that you will get sigma fi. This is sigma fi. You will get this. So now you have to prepare fi into xi, that is fi into xi, that is the products of the frequencies and observations. Here 5 into 3, that is 15, 10 tenja, 100, 25 into 15, that is 375, 20 into 7, that is 140, and 25 faija 125. If you add all these things, you will get sigma fi into xi, that is equal to, so 5 3 ja 15, 1 plus 2 3, 7 plus 7 14 plus 1 15, and here 1 plus 1 2 3, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. So here the sigma fi xi is 755. And what is the sigma fi? That is the sum of all frequencies. So here 25 plus 5, 30 plus 10, 40 plus 7 plus 3, 10. That is 50. Total you have, the sum of all frequencies 50. Just you have to write the values in this formula. So mean through direct method or simple method. So this is a frequent ungrouped frequency distribution table. Why it is ungrouped? There were no groups, that is there were no classes, just observations and frequency are given in a table. That is why this is called ungrouped frequency distribution table. For this one, we are finding the mean through simple method. This the formula is sigma fi xi by sigma fi. So here mean is represented as x bar. What is the value of sigma fi xi? 755 by 50. So simplify it, that is x bar is equal to 5 10 ja 50. So here 5 1 ja 5, 5 5 ja and 5 1 ja, 151 by 10. So this x bar is equal to 150 by 10. You can write it as 15.1. So the mean of this ungrouped frequency distribution table is 15.1. In this way, you can find the mean of ungrouped frequency distribution table using this formula. Okay. Now, one more question. Take one more question. So So second question. Second question. So here Marx and the number of students are given. So the marks 5 marks were secured by 3 students, 6, 10, 7 marks, 17 members, 8 marks, some A members, and 9 marks, 8, and 10 marks, 4 members. So this is the frequency, ungrouped frequency distribution table. So here is a condition: if the mean of the data is 7.5. Here we are not going to find the mean for this data. Mean of this data is given as 7.5. Then find the value of A, that's the unknown quantity A. So here also we have to use this simple method only. How to find the value of A? So here the marks are taken as the observations xi, and now the number of students as frequency. These two items were given in the table. So in the marks 5 and 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. These are the marks. Observations. This observation occurs 3 times. That is, this is 3 and 10, 17. And next one, A times. And this is 8, and it's a 4. So here we have to find the sigma fi xi. We know the mean through simple method, mean x bar is equal to sigma fi into xi by sigma fi. First you have to remember this formula, so that you can prepare the required items. What are the required items here? Sigma fi is required. This is the required one. Sigma fi. And we have to find fi into xi. This is also the required one. You have to find this sum also. So here, find the product of these two. 5 into 3, that is 15. 10 into 6, that is 60, and 17 into 7, 7, 7 ja 49, 7, 1 ja 119, 8 into A, that is 8A, 9, 8 ja 72, 10, 4 ja 40. So you have to add all these things. So 17 plus 3, 20, this is plus 10, 30. 38 plus 4, 42 plus A. This is 42 plus A. You have to write in this way only, not 42A. 42 plus A. So if you add all these things, you are going to get 8A. You have to write in separate way. And you add 15, 60, 119 and 72, 40. You are going to get 306. Okay. So this is sigma fi and this is sigma fi into xi. So now here our task is to find the value of A. here mean is given. So just substitute the values here. The mean is 7.5 is equal to sigma fi xi is 306 plus 80a by what is sigma fi 42 plus a. Okay, so now you have to simplify this one. So there is nothing in the denominator means 1, just you cross multiply it. That is 306 into 1, 306 plus 80a is equal to, so now 7.5 into 42, 42 into, just multiply in rough, 42 into 7.5, 5 2 jar 10, 5 4 jar 20, 21, 7 2 jar 14, and 7 4 jar 28 plus 129. So 0, 5 and 11, that is 31. After this decimal point, we have one digit, therefore, so now the value is 315 plus 7.5 into a, 7.5a. So bring like terms aside. Here 7a is here, minus 7.5a is equal to 315 minus 306, isn't it? So 8a minus 7.5a, this is 0.5a, is equal to 315 minus 306 is 9. So now we have to find the value of a. A is equal to, of course you can write 0.5 is nothing but 1 by 2, a is equal to 9. That implies a is equal to 9 into 2, 18. So this is the required value. Okay, here we know that. Once again, here the mean is given, we have to find the value of a using the simple method or direct method. Here this table is ungrouped frequency distribution table. The marks are taken as the observations xi and this is the frequency. So here we have to find the mean through simple method, sigma fi xi by sigma fi. So here after adding all these values, you get sigma fi, that is 42 plus a, and the products of this fi and xi, sum of all these things is 306 plus 80a. Just plug in the values. So that you will get, after simplification, the value of A is 18. The unknown quantity is found in this way. Okay. So in your 9.2 exercise, you have problems on this formula. Try to complete it. Okay. Is there any alternate method to find the mean for ungrouped distribution table? So another way, that is the mean of ungrouped, next one, mean of ungrouped frequency distribution, frequency distribution fusion by deviation method. Deviation method. This is one more method to find the arithmetic mean of ungrouped frequency distribution method. In deviation method, the formula is here, mean is equal to, that is, mean is represented by x bar, mean is equal to a plus sigma fi into di by sigma fi. So here we can write this a. A is the assumed mean among from observations. So here one new letter, that is di, deviation, the ith deviation. What is the deviation? This is the difference between xi and a. So xi is the observation and a is the assumed mean among from observations. Okay, and here sigma fi, that is the sum of all frequencies, and here sigma fi di is, sigma means sum of fi and di, means products of fi and di. What is deviation? Deviation is the difference between the observations and the corresponding, the assumed mean among from observations. Sometimes you may questioned like this, write the mean of ungrouped frequency distribution through deviation method. So what is the formula? Mean through deviation method is a plus sigma fi di by sigma fi. Here you have to write the meaning of each letter, that is a. A is assumed mean among from observations. How you are going to assume the value of a, we will see within short period. And di is the deviation, that is the difference between these two values. And sigma fi, you know, that is sum of all observations. Of course, sometimes this is denoted by n also, small n or capital N. Sigma fi di is sum of products of fi and di. Okay, now let us take one question on this method. So here is a question. So here xi 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, and fi is 4, 5, 8, 10, 7, 4, and 2. This is the ungrouped frequency distribution table. Find the mean through deviation method. So he specified the method in which way we have to find the mean. So if he is not specified, you can use either simple method or deviation method also. So now, so using deviation method, we have a formula, that is a plus sigma fi di by sigma fi. You have to remember that formula so that you can prepare the table. So here xi, and here fi. These two values were given. Xi is 10 and 12, 14, 16, 18, 20 and 22. These are the values. So now we have to find the deviations. What is di? Di is equal to xi minus a. This is the deviation. We have to find the differences between the observations and a. A is assumed mean among from the observations here. So now after finding the differences, you have to find fi into di. Okay. So we have to find the sigma fi value and this one sigma fi di value. These two values are to be find. So here fi is given 4 and 5, 8, 10, 7 and 4, 2. So here the very important task is to find a. So here a is the assumed mean among from observations. So these are the observations. So what is a? How to find a? In general, the a, that is the assumed mean, is taken opposite to the highest frequency. Here the highest frequency is 10. So that is why opposite to this 10 on left side we have 16. This is taken as a. This is the in general. We are taking the value opposite to the maximum frequency is a. Can we take any observation as a? Let us discuss later on what is going after taking any value. Is there any difference or not? Okay. So now taking this as a, we have to find xi minus a. This is the xi minus a. 10 minus 16, that is minus 6. And 12 minus 16, that is minus 4. And this is, of course, you may write like this also, like an equation. Xi is 10 minus 16, that is equal to minus 6. Okay? And 12 minus 16, that is equal to minus 4. And 14 minus 16, that is equal to minus 2. So here the xi is 16, minus 16, that is equal to 0. Here 18 is the xi, minus 16, that is equal to 2. And 20 minus 16 is equal to 4. And here 22 is the xi, minus 16, that is equal to 6. So now what we have to find fi into di? 4 into minus 6, minus 24, and here 5 into minus 4, minus 20, 8 into minus 2, minus 16, 10 into 0, this is 0. So now 7 into 2, 14, and 4 into 4, that is 16, and 2 into 6, 12. Okay, now you have to find the sum of all these frequencies, sigma fi, this is 4 plus 5, 9, 9 plus 8, 17, 27 plus 7, 34 plus 4, 38 plus 2, 40. So you have, this is the sigma fi. So now this is sigma fi into di. So how you are going to find here, the negative values are here and the positive values are here. Here you can add all these things, that is minus 4 plus 6, 10, and 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1 plus 1, that is minus 60. And here, the positive values, you can add all these things so that you get 4 plus 6, 10 plus 2, 12, and this is 42. So here the sigma FIDA is minus 60 plus 42, that is equal to minus 18. Minus 60 plus 42, you have to subtract 42 from 60 and put the minus sign. Okay, so now you have to write the formula mean. Mean is equal to mean x bar is equal to a plus sigma fi into di by sigma fi. So here, what is the value of a from table? A 16 plus sigma fi di value is minus 18 by sigma fi value 40. So you have to write like this. Now simplify it. 16 plus into minus minus 18 by 40. Okay. So now 16 minus. So 4 table, 4 10 ja 40. 4 4 ja 16. 5. So that is 16 4.5 by 10, that is equal to 16 minus 4.5 is divided by 10, point moves left side, that is 0.45, that is equal to 16 minus 0.45. So is there a point for 16? Yes, 16 after you can put the point. After that, you have two digits after decimal point, that is why take two zeros and 0.45. So subtract. So here you have to cut this one 5 and 9, 10. 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 4, 5 and 5, and this is 1. So here the answer is 15.55. So here the median, the mean for this ungrouped frequency distribution table using deviation method. Okay. So after finding, after fixing the value A, we have to find the deviations and the product of fi and dy. And in the deviation method, here is a formula, mean is equal to a plus sigma fi di by sigma fi. So after substitute these values, a is 16 and plus sigma fi di is minus 18 by 40. After simplification, you get 15.55. So now let us see why I have to, is it mandatory to take A against the maximum value of the frequency? No, it is not necessary. Let us see. So what is A? It is assumed mean among from observations. I can take any of these observations as A. So let us see what is happen. Suppose if I am not taking the 16 as A, now you are going to get these values the another way. So let us see. So here in this, the answer is 15.55. Remember this one. Now I am taking A as the first value. This is the A. What happens? Let us see. The method is same. Just the change is selecting A from observations. Usually we are selecting the assumed mean against the maximum frequency. Now we are seeing whether there is any difference or not by taking any of the observations as A. So now let us take 10 as assumed mean. So now what is DI? DI is XI minus A. What is XI here? 10 minus 10. 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. So here XI is 12. 12 minus 10 is equal to 2. And here XI 14 minus 10. That is 4. 16 minus 10. That is equal to 6. 18 minus 10 is equal to 8. And 20 minus 10 is equal to 10. And 22 minus 10 is equal to 12. So these are the deviations. Now we have to find Fi into Di. 4 into 0, that is 0. 5 into 2, 10. 8, 4 ja, 32. 10 into 6, 60. 7, 8 ja, 56. 4, 10 ja, 40. And 2, 12 ja, 24. So now add Fi and Di. So 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. And here 1 is here. So here 6 plus 3, 9 plus 1, 10. 15. 15 plus these 2, 5. That is 20 plus 2, 22. Triple 2. So this is nothing but sigma Fi in Di. Now the formula of mean through deviation method is the same. That is mean is equal to A plus sigma Fi Di by sigma Fi. So now the mean X bar is equal to, what is the value of A here? That is 10 plus sigma Fi Di. So here we have triple 2 by the sigma Fi is 40 only. So now X bar is equal to 10 plus, you have to simplify it. So can we divide with 4 table? Yes, 4 10 ja is 40, and here 4 5 ja 20, 2 remains, 22, 4 5 ja 20. And suppose if you take the decimal point, another 20 is there, 4 5 ja 20. So that is 55.5 by 10. Here X bar is equal to 10 plus 55.5 divided by 10 means the while dividing with 10 and powers of 10, the point, decimal point, moves left side. How many places here? 10 is in the denominator, we have only 1 0, that is why one place towards left side you have to move, that is 5.55. So now X bar is equal to, add these two, 10 plus 5.55, that is 15.55. So this is the mean of this ungrouped data. In the earlier we have taken A as 16 so that we get the mean of the data is 15.55 only. So now in this situation I have taken the first observation as mean of the data, that is assumed mean. That is why you can assume any value from the observations. given in the table so that you can find the mean, and that mean is same, that does not alter by taking the values, any value in this observation as A. Okay, so in this way you can find the mean of ungrouped frequency distribution table through deviation method. Okay, so up to now we discussed there are three central tendencies and they are arithmetic mean, sometimes called as average or simply mean. Okay, we are finding the mean for raw data through three ways. So mean for raw data is yesterday's formula, mean is equal to sum of all observations by number of observations. That is, if the raw data is given, we have to apply that formula. Suppose if the frequency distribution, ungrouped frequency distribution tables were given, if too many observations are there, if some observation repeats more time, then we have to prepare this table. Otherwise, if the table is given, you have to apply the simple method, that is sometimes called direct method. What is the direct method? If he is not asking like this, you can go through with the first method. That is, here is xi and fi. The first method, in simple method or direct method, the mean of the data is sigma fi xi by sigma fi. So here particularly in this question he is asking that to find the mean through deviation method. That is why we have to find the deviations here. So what is the formula for the ungrouped frequency distribution through deviation method? Mean is equal to A plus sigma fi da by sigma fi. Here A is the assumed mean among from observations only. In general, A is selected the value which is opposite to the maximum frequency. It is not mandatory. We can select any of the observations as A. This is very important point you have to catch. In your next, that is 10th class, you are going to have problems on this method. That is why you have to concentrate on the sums. In your 9.2 exercise, you have questions on this formula. So you try to complete them, and in the next class we are going to discuss two more central tendency values. They are the median and the mode. Okay, see you.